Today's kitchen. Today for dinner, our main course is going to be rotisserie chicken. And Rick is going to be in charge of the cooking of this on the grill. So he's going to be showing you how to get it set up, and then we'll see him in the midst of cooking it. But I'm going to get us started by telling you what we have here. This is one whole chicken, and the way it's labeled is it's all natural, and it's free of hormones and stuff like that. It's a whole chicken. I guess it's kind of covered up with the label right there. But when you buy this, it's going to be clamped together up at the top or bottom, and you need to undo that. And there will probably be some liquid in here, and I usually just drain that down the sink. You can see we don't need that, and it just kind of gets in the way. And I'm going to be rinsing this anyway, so let me first just kind of rinse that out and then see what we've got here. I did wash the sink earlier so that we would have clean space to work with, and I'm going to set this aside, which I don't want to handle a lot and then handle other things, so I'll make sure that I just put this aside and take care of it in the garbage later. Now this is a 4-pound chicken, and what you need to do is look inside, and you'll find that there's a little bag which has the giblets. And the giblets here, we have a neck bone, I can feel that, and then there's liver, a heart, and other organ meats that we're not going to be using. I might boil those up and let Remy, the little dog, have them, but I'm just going to set them aside for now. Won't worry about that. So what I want to do is use the back of my hand here so I won't be touching the faucet, and I'm going to just rinse this off. I want that a little colder. Put it in the wrong direction. So we just let the water run all the way through and around and try to get under the wings and the legs until it's thoroughly rinsed. Now, I'm gonna rinse off my hand a little bit and turn the water off. Now, I'm gonna shake this some, get any excess water off, and then put it in some kind of container so that water will not run off the edge. A flat plate really wouldn't be good, so I've got a nice hefty container here. So I'm gonna meet you over here and season it up in just a minute. Let me tell you what I've done so far with the chicken. I noticed that there was some extra fat. For one thing, there was a tail here that is totally fat, so you don't need that. So I took that off with kitchen shears, and then there was a flap of fat on each side down here, and that was really not going to be helpful in any way. Now, some of the fat that remains on here is okay, because that kind of works its way into the chicken meat, and it bastes the chicken, so it's helpful. Now what I did beyond trimming it up a little bit was to fold the wings back behind, and then I put olive oil, you'll see what I have over here, olive oil over all of it, even inside it. Went up inside it from both ends, and then I did grind some sea salt. I'm not touching these because I'm touching the chicken. I did grind some sea salt, which you can use regular salt if you like. I did grind some peppercorns. Again, you can use regular ground black pepper if you like, but I went over all of it. I went over the top side, and then I turned it over and went over the bottom side, and then I made sure I got in all the crevices under the wings and under the legs, and then going up inside. And this flavoring from the seasoning and the oil is permeating all of the chicken, so that's going to be nice as it cooks. The flavor will cook into it, and it will be wonderful. So I think it's time for me to turn this over to Rick. He's the barbecue master around here, and he's going to turn this into rotisserie chicken.
I've got this rotisserie attachment, which goes into the grill. It just turns it constantly. And that's the beauty of it. You could cook these on a grill, on a beer can or on a wire rack, sitting on the grill in a static position, but that's not as good as rotating it, which keeps it cooking evenly, which helps to distribute the juices And just make sure that it's cooked evenly. Stick this basket on both sides. Tuck the legs up a little bit. And I'm ready to set it on the grill.
Okay, so we'll see Rick outside at the grill. This is going to take about how long?
To cook the thing?
Yes.
I think about an hour and a half, probably, is my best guess.
So maybe halfway through, and then when it's done, you'll get to see a shot of Rick at the grill with the chicken.
Here we go, sliding it in. And just flip a switch. And it turns. It's like magic.
So it's just now started. It's going to be a little while, so we'll be fixing some of the rest of dinner in the meantime. But I'll come back and show you maybe some progress. If nothing else, I'll show you when it's done.
I think our chicken is done. It's been an hour and 45 minutes. And you can take a look at it. It's pretty well roasted up. The skin looks nice. This is what's been actually cooking it. It's an infrared heater from the back, not from below. And I just put a little piece of aluminum foil down here to capture the drippings, keep it a little cleaner. Let me turn this off, take it up.
The rotisserie chicken that Rick is responsible for mainly. All I did was to wash it and season it a little bit. But you can see that it looks really nice on a platter like this. I've got a little rosemary here to decorate my platter. Here are the two breasts, and they browned up very nicely. And then the two wings here. And then you see the leg portions, the thigh and the leg over here and also over here. Now there was more chicken meat, but it just was not going, it was going to be in chunks, so we did not put it on the platter. So this is basically it, and I want to show you my plate tonight for dinner. I've already put some macaroni and cheese deluxe on there because I made that today. And then I like the breast meat. Now I won't take all of this myself, I'll split it with somebody else in the family, but that looks good, I think, on here. And then, we also made today this dish, which is stewed tomatoes. So I usually avoid bread in my meals. You've probably noticed that. Sometimes I will make them a feature, like Italian bread or French bread done a certain way. But when I'm watching calories, I always notice that bread has a little more calories than a lot of things. So you may see my meals missing that. So all I've done is to give you the meat, and a side here, and then a vegetable here, and a nice glass of iced tea.